Distinguished colleagues and guests, ladies and gentlemen, I am glad to have such a defense today with such an interesting topic, and please allow me to consider open the meeting of the Dissertation Council for the Defense of Chirkov Nikolai Viktorovich Thesis for the candidate degree of philosophy on speciality 09-00-14, philosophy of religion and religious studies, on the topic the inculturation of Christianity into the ethic traditions of nations in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. According to the order of St. Petersburg State University from the 8th of June 2019, Mishakhnovich Mariana Mikhailovna, Doctor of Philosophy Professor, was appointed the chairperson of this thesis council. And also allow me to introduce my fellow board members. First of all, our colleagues who are working in the remote interactive mode. I would like to express my gratitude to them for their participation in this, in the meeting of this council. It is very excellent. Ekaterina Sergeyevna Elbaikyan, Doctor of Philosophy, Russian Presidential Academy of National Economy and Public Administration from Moscow. Good afternoon, dear Ekaterina Sergeyevna. I hope that you can hear us. Well, glad to see you today. And distinguished Teresa Balevich, Doctor of Philosophy, Pontifical University of John Paul II in Krakow, Poland. Distinguished Sister Teresa, I'm glad to welcome you here. Thank you very much for participation in this meeting, and also my fellow board members from St. Petersburg State University, Tatiana Vituasovna Chumakova, Doctor of Philosophy, and Anastasia Andreevna Palomarchuk, Doctor of Historical Sciences. And today our dissertation council is politically correct from the point of view of gender equality. And I think it's a brilliant event today. First of all, I would like to emphasize that according to the federal law on science and state scientific and technical policy, our university has the right to independently award academic degrees. And there is a corresponding order. And in accordance with this order, the meeting of the Dissertation Council is considered eligible if at least two-thirds of the approved membership of the Dissertation Council take part in its work. There are five members of the Council's audiovisual contact is provided. We have got a quorum. And the procedure of today's meeting, with a total duration of no more than 2 hours, is the following, maybe less than 2 hours. The first chairman summary report on the main content of the documents submitted by the candidate, 5 minutes. Brief report of the candidate for the degree reflecting the main points of his research, up to 15 minutes, maybe less. Questions to the candidate strictly according to his report. Then I am going to read out all the external reviews and the answers of our candidates. Then the speeches of all the members of the thesis council by turns with reviews, no more than 10 minutes for the speaker. As far as I understand, our candidate will answer the questions of the board members by turns. Okay, by turns. And then open discussion at the request of those present at the defense of the thesis. After that, the speech of the scientific supervisor. Unfortunately, Andrei Pavlovich Zabiyaka is missing. He lives in the town of Blagoveshchensk in the Far East. He submitted his review. We will listen to his review. Then we are going to have discussion before an open vote and the broadcast will be switched off during this discussion, and then open individual voting and the decision on awarding or not awarding a scientific degree, and then the final word of our applicants. It is a very important moment. I would like to emphasize that not only our colleagues present here via Skype, but there is a broadcast of our defense on the internet, and all those who want to watch this defense, there is live broadcast at the website of St. Petersburg State University, and also this simultaneous interpretation from Russian into English and from English into Russian is also provided. Nikolai Viktorovich, please be seated for a moment. Please be seated. Also, I'm not comfortable when you are standing at the rostrum. There is thesis by Chirkov Nikolai Viktorovich, submitted for the scientific degree of the candidate of philosophical sciences 09014 on the topic the inculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations and the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. It was accepted for the defense by the scientific secretary of St. Petersburg State University from the 8th of June 2019. The candidate submitted the following documents: an application form addressed to the rector of St. Petersburg State University, the diploma of higher education issued by Amur State University, certifying that our candidate received the qualification of regional studies, the review of scientific supervisor, the list of publication containing 9 works outlining the main scientific results of the thesis, including 8 articles published in peer-reviewed scientific publications from the list approved by the Ministry of Education and Science of the Russian Federation. All the candidate examinations were successfully passed with the mark excellent, and specialty exam was also successfully passed. The thesis is done in Russian and English, both in paper-based version as a manuscript and in the electronic form. All listed documents comply with paragraph 12 of section 3, presentation and defense of dissertations. Procedure for awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University. There are no questions concerning the documents submitted by our candidate. And now, please allow me to give the floor to our candidate. With his report, Mariana Mikhailovna, thank you very much. Good afternoon, dear colleagues and guests, members of the dissertation councils. I present to your attention a paper on the topic the inculturation of Christianity in the ethnic traditions of peoples in the missionary work of the Roman Catholic Church. First of all, I would like to say a few words about the relevance of the research topic. To preach Christianity among non-Christian peoples, the Roman Catholic Church resorted to the use of inculturation of Christianity, a set of social, religious, and social-cultural approaches of the missionary activities of the Roman Catholic Church, which consists in adapting Christian doctrine and liturgical practice and taking into account the cultural and religious realities of various ethnic groups. Evidence of this process is new ways of evangelism and forms of worship among various nations, translations of liturgical and church literature into national languages, where Roman Catholic Church, in order to better perceive the basic doctrinal ideas by the local population, explicates concepts from local religious beliefs and cultural paradigms. Moreover, the manifestation of this phenomenon can be clearly seen in the emergence of new artistic styles in church art, namely in the architecture, exterior, interior of Catholic liturgical premises, which harmoniously fit into the national flavor of specific religions. If before the process of inculturation of Christianity was not paid so much attention, now this topic begins to develop actively not only in church articles, But also in academic religion and humanities. The methods of inculturation of Christianity are actively used by Catholic missionaries in Russia, in particular in Yakutia. New forms of Christian preaching appear, adapted to the mentality and culture of Yakuts. In this regard, the inculturation of Christianity as a strategy for its dissemination in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church, as well as a process of mutual influence and transformation of conflicting cultures. Due to the fact that the translations of the definition of inculturation of Christianity in Russian language, theological and scientific religious literature have an ambiguous interpretation, it becomes necessary to clarify the understanding of this concept in the missionary work of the Roman Catholic Church. The process of inculturation of Christianity takes place in all regions where the Roman Catholic Church carries out its missionary activities. It was not possible to cover the ethno-religious components of all regions in this work. Therefore, several of the most accessible regions were identified for the objective and subjective reasons. The following regions became the objects of field research: Brazil, China, and Italy. In Russia, the Republic of Sakha, Yakutia was identified as a study region due to the fact that the Republic of, for more than 25 years, Catholic missionaries have been trying to adapt Catholicism among the local population. In my opinion, of all the subjects of Russia, both the strategy and the process of inculturation of Christianity are the most pronounced in Yakutia, possibly due to the fact that the Republic retains its traditional culture and language, and partly religious beliefs that contrast with Christianity. Some elements of the Yakut culture and beliefs have common ground with certain aspects of Christianity that missionaries used in inculturing Christianity. Therefore, a significant part of this study relies directly on the results of the analysis of field material collected during ethno-religious expeditions in Yakutia from 2008 to 2016. As for the source, empirical base of research, we can say the following based on the fact that the concept of inculturation of Christianity originates from the terminology of the Roman Catholic Church. To study the interpretation of this definition in my work, I directly turn to the analysis of official documents by Holy See, the copies of which are decisions of Second Vatican Council, the Catechism of Catholic Church, the Compendium of Social Studies of the Roman Catholic Church, and so on. Next, I would like to outline the object, subject, and purpose of my research. The object of this research is the process of enculturation of Christianity in the ethnic traditions of peoples. The subject of the research is the explication of the methods, aspects, and form of the enculturation of Christianity in the missionary activities of the Roman Catholic Church, in particular in Yakutia. The aim of this work is to provide holistic characteristics of the process of enculturation of Christianity in the ethnic traditions of peoples living in the territory of missionary activity as a strategy for the spread of Christian religion in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. To achieve the goal, the following tasks were formulated, each of which corresponds to the specific paragraph in my work. All the tasks are displayed in the presentation as well as in the brochure. And I will move on to the main part of my presentation. Regarding the novelty of the dissertation research, it should be said that the dissertation is the first study of Russian religious study. The provisions are the following. The first provision that needs to be identified together with the scientific supervisor of the work, Doctor of Philosophy, Professor Andrei Pavlovich Zabiyaka, the introduction of the new interpretation of the definition used in the work of the scientific interpretation of the definition of inculturation of Christianity from the perspective of academic religion is proposed and justified. The inculturation of Christianity is a strategy for its dissemination, which is based on the study of the culture of Christianized people, the adaptation of certain aspects of this culture to the norms of Christianity. The inculturation of Christianity is a social, religious, and ethnocultural process. According to the position of the Roman Curia, the task of inculturation is to preach Christianity from the perspective of transforming and penetrating in the existing cultures with the gospel, taking into account the ability of the Roman Catholic Church to adapt to different culture. Inculturation of Christianity is the one of the leading principles of the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. The development of aspects, methods, and forms of inculturation of Christianity received theological justification in the writings on the pontiffs of the Roman Catholic Church. The inculturation of Christianity has a significant position in the development of interreligious and intercultural dialogues in the Roman Catholic Church. According to the Roman Catholic Church, the development of these dialogues is focused on preparing ways for evangelization and adaptation of Christianity among local cultures. In the process of inculturation of Christianity, cultural transformation of both conflicting cultures are revealed. This process is mutual. On the one hand, there is a transformation of traditional religious ideas of the indigenous population under the influence of Catholicism. On the other hand, the Catholic doctrine itself is the process of inculturation acquires completely new forms and elements. In particular, several aspects can be distinguished in the inculturation of Christianity: visual, linguistic, and actional. The visual aspect of visualizing images and concepts through the visual arts, interior and exterior of Catholic liturgical premises, is one of the most significant methods of preaching Christian doctrine among non-Christian peoples. The linguistic aspect is manifested in translations and adaptations of doctrinal literature and the Bible into local languages, as well as in the use of local languages in worship and other rites. The promotional aspect is expressed by the search for new forms of reproduction, the cult ritual practice of the Roman Catholic Church, and the adaptation of Catholic worship to the realia of local cultures. The strategy of the conciliation of Christianity is actively implemented by Catholic missionaries in Yakutia and is also expressed in the three aspects of adaptation to the culture and mentality of the Saha people. Visual aspect, this type, structure, name, and interior of the Catholic liturgical premises are closely associated with elements of the traditional culture and religious beliefs of the Yakuts. The main feature is the image of Jesus Christ, the Virgin Mary, and the apostles, having features inherent in the Yakut natural type, mongoloid appearance. Iconographic images are frescoes, and frescoes use colors close to cultural context and traditions of the Yakuts. According to missionaries, such methods should facilitate easier perception of Catholic liturgical premises by local peoples and help to bring to them the ideas of values of Christianity through visual aspect and its expression in various pictorial forms. The linguistic aspect is expressed by translation of church doctrinal liturgical literature into the Yakut language. In the Holy Scriptures, the name of God, the names of sacred hypostases in translation are partly borrowed from the traditional religious beliefs of the Yakuts and adapted in the context of the Christian interpretation. In the Bible and other Christian literature in the Yakut language, one can find the designation of the Christian God under Yakuti names Tantara, Ayitayon, interpreting him as a heavenly beginning of Creator. The linguistic aspect also involves the study by the missionaries of the Yakut language and its use in divine services and other religious Catholic rites in the Republic. The promotional aspect is expressed in the ways and forms of worship and other religious rites of the Roman Catholic Church, taking into account the elements and symbols of the traditional Saha culture. A specific example of the adaptation of the form of the prayer, Our Father, in the context of the national culture of the Yakuts is the non-traditional form of the prayer, reminiscent of the element of the traditional Yakut dance, Osuhai. In the spring and summer period, services can be performed in the open air, often in the vicinity of rivers and reservoirs, or in the steppes. In the religious ceremonies among the Yakut population, missionaries often use fire and water, which also demonstrates one of the forms of adaptation of Catholic liturgical rites to the culture of local peoples. And the last provision, which I want to emphasize, is the primary task of missionaries is to assimilate the culture, religious traditions, and rites of the Yakuts. This task includes the search and borrowing of some ideas acceptable to Christianity, elements of culture, and religious beliefs, in order to build a specific strategy for preaching. According to the missionaries, this task contains certain difficulties caused by two reasons. Firstly, a foreign missionary is confronted with the alien culture, religious beliefs, language, and mentality. The process of learning culture And language is a prerequisite for the adaptation of missionary and requires a significant amount of time. Secondly, in the interpretation of the foundations of Christian doctrine by the language of culture and the beliefs of the Yakuts, there is a likelihood of religious syncretism among the evangelized people. This confirms our thesis that the inculturation of Christianity there is a mutual transformation of two conflicting cultures, on the one hand Catholic, on the other hand local, in this case Yakut. From standpoint of the Roman Catholic Church, the emergence of religion syncretism is negative and considered as a threatening factor for the negative perception of Christian doctrine. Please, thank you for your attention. Nikolai Viktorovich, thank you very much. Dear colleagues, distinguished members of the dissertation boards, do you have any questions? Dr. Abalevich, Anastasia Andreevna. I would like to ask the question. How can you see the correlation of syncretism and culturation? You know that culturation is the first stage towards syncretism, or it is a different phenomenon. Thank you very much for your question. It is the second variant. To my mind, it is a derivative of inculturation of Christianity. Thank you very much. Ekaterina Sergeyevna, are you satisfied with the answer? Nikolai Viktorovich, are there any other questions? No questions. Nikolai Viktorovich, please be seated. And now we are going to read out our review. Please be seated. Now, the reviews. I would like to draw your attention that both board members and guests, there is an external review. It is a very rare event. It proves that the dissertation is of high interest among the academic community. There is a review from the Doctor of Historical Sciences, Associate Professor, Head on the Department of Regional Study of Russian of the State University of Altai, Pyotr Konstantinovich Dashkovsky. And please allow me to read out his review. The thesis paper is dedicated to complex, poorly studied problem methods of penetration and adaptation of Christianity to non-Christian peoples. The study of the processes of inculturation of Christianity is very relevant both for the Church in connection with its missionary activity and for the researchers of religion and philosophy of religions. Inculturation, it is a set of intercultural dialogue and interaction. It leads to the better understanding of other religion and culture. It is very important for the elaboration of the ways of peaceful existence. But there are a range of problems connected with the approaches. It is necessary to highlight that this dissemination of Christianity has always been connected with inculturation. Mission, apostleship is connected with various cultures. Throughout the history of the Roman Catholic Church, there were different levels of inculturation. Practical level was connected with the translation of Holy Scripture to the languages of other people who are not familiar with monotheistic religious tradition. And the lingua-cultural level of inculturation is connected with the search of the lexis. And helped cult behavior of people involved into cultural practice. And the next level of inculturation is connected with the understanding of another culture. In modern religious science, there are three models of missionary activity of Roman Catholic Church. The first model manifested in the practice of religious activity of 16th, 17th century. Then adaptational model came at the end of the 19th century, and the cultural adaptation of Christianity was made with the help of soft methods. Since the second half of the 20th century, in the missionary activity of Catholic Church, the model of inculturation of Christianity was developed. The Second Vatican Council appeared. It is the method of missionary activity which characterizes the necessity to accept missionary intercultural dialogue. Secondly, it is the process of Christianity reception of cultural space of non-Christian people. In the introduction of the thesis, the actuality of the thesis of the studies explained, the author presented the attempt of an ethnocultural location of field researchers, Brazil, China, Italy, the Russian Federation, the Republic of Sakha, Yakutia. Unfortunately, the author did not represent the criteria of the division of the location of his field research. If in China and Russia this field practice is correlated, but the variant of Christianity in culturation in Italy and Brazil is different from the point of view of the method and the whole process of enculturation. And such methods can be used as an example of the comparative analysis of the missionary activity. And the extent of the study of the enculturation of Christianity says that this topic is poorly studied. Demchenko, Kovalevskaya, Dubravskaya, Lamanov are mentioned, whereas Maximov, the works of Maximov, Mananikov, Min, and a range of other scholars are not included into the study. In the light, the first task of the thesis, the characteristics of the extent of the study of the literary sources includes the study of Father Pope Benedict XVI, and the author did not conduct the analysis of the legacy. In the introduction, he stresses the goals and tasks of the research, which are correlated with the provisions for the defense. Here, he speaks about non-Christian people, about people connected with pagan tradition. The subject of the research and why do you explicate why did you choose Yakut and not other regions as well? Novelty, methodology, provisions for the defense, approbations, and scientific significance are very clear. In the first chapter of the thesis, the author categorizes enculturation of Christianity, and also he characterizes the process of enculturation of Christianization, the background of two process, accommodation and evangelization. As for the characteristics of nevertheless, the author does not polemize with his predecessors, and it impedes understanding author's contribution into the study. The author, what is the difference? The attention should be paid to the aspect of the influence of the cultures into the Catholic religion. The methods of intercultural dialects should be paid attention to. There are a lot of characteristics of intercultural and interreligious dialogue, and the author does not analyze the reasons for such reglementation of intercultural dialogue within the process of inculturation. Then the model of inculturation, visual linguistic aspects, the author addresses various traditions which are far from the realia of inculturation in Yakuts. After Christianization of Yakutia, the notion of about a dominant deity was confused with the notion about God. Without doubt, the most original part of the study is this fourth chapter of the Thesis. The author represents the historical review of the adaptation of Christianity within the frames of Orthodox mission. As for intercultural dialogue, our candidates in the sociological literature, there is opinion that today missionaries use the specific of life dialogue. In connection to that, I would like you to specify what which of intercultural and interreligious dialogue are most popular in Yakutia. On the whole, the thesis is done on the high research level. Provisions for the defense are reflected throughout the thesis, and in the conclusion of the thesis, the ideas of the authors are independent and of high attention. The work was tested at Russian conferences. Our candidate collected field religion studies material, which he successfully used in his work. He is good at foreign language, and he used the information from the English literary sources. There are 12 works published by the author. 9 of them are published in peer-reviewed journals. Despite all these remarks, the thesis was prepared by our candidate. And our candidate deserves the degree of the candidate of philosophical sciences, and our candidate deserves the degree of the candidate of sciences on speciality philosophy of religion and religious studies. Mariana Mikhailovna, thank you very much. Distinguished Peter Konstantinovich, I would like to express my gratitude to the interest towards my thesis. I agree with your remarks, and I would like to comment upon some of them. As for the remark on the location of field research, the process of inculturation of Christianity takes place along the entire historical path of the development of the Roman Catholic Church, as well as in all regions where the Catholic Church carries out its missionary activity. There is no general criterion for choosing locations. and I proceeded from subjective and objective reasons. I tried to describe the objective reason in detail in this section in the introduction of the book. As for the subjective reason, it is due to the fact that in this republic I carried out a number of studies related to culture and religious beliefs, and over the years of research I managed to collect extensive material that allowed for a comparative analysis. I chose Yakutia as a region for the study of inculturation in Russia because in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church in this republic, there are all three aspects of Christian inculturation that I describe: visual, linguistic, and promotional. In Brazil, for the most part, it was interesting to study the aspect of inculturation of Christianity. As for Italy, I agree with you. Perhaps this is not my very successful formulation. In Italy, the Missionary Museum of the Roman Catholic Church and their foundations were of great interest to my research. And based on the fact that missionaries from the monastic congregation of Salesians carried out missionary activity. My goal was to demonstrate the inculturation of Christianity as a missionary strategy of the Roman Catholic Church. There are many examples of the inculturation of Christianity because each case is unique. Therefore, it is not possible to describe all cases within the framework of one dissertation. However, once again, I thank you for your remark. As for study of the topic, the wording is fair and sufficiently studied in Russian religious researchers. I agree with you that the work you have listed contains valuable material. I will definitely take it into account in my further scientific work, especially in writing the planned monograph on this topic. About the work of Mananikov, I did not know regarding the difference between the inculturation of Christianity from Christianization of the Roman Catholic Church refers to the process of spreading Christian doctrine as a whole. The inculturation of Christianity is a specific strategy that takes into account the cultural, religious, and linguistic features of the local culture in the spread of Christianity. However, I agree with your remark because it will help in future work to avoid this nuance in understanding and distinguishing between the two terms. In the second chapter, I really do not analyze the reasons that caused such a large-scale regulation of intercultural dialogue in the framework of Christian inculturation. The objectives of my research included an analysis of the significance of the inculturation of Christianity in the inculturation and interreligious dialogue. I partially described this issue in two articles in the journal Religious Studies. In more detail, in the article, The Inculturation of Christianity in the Context of Intercultural and Interreligious Dialogue of the Roman Catholic Church, published in the mentioned edition in the first issue of 2018. Regarding the interpretation of Yakut theonym Ivy, historically they accumulated the Christian concept of God, but was assimilated among the Yakuts at the time of first and second waves of Christianization of the Republic, only as a designation of the name of God. It is necessary to note the current problems of the translation of the Trinity into the Yakut language. It is quite difficult for the Yakut mentality to understand the concept of one God in three phases: the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In 2011, a new translation of the Bible into the modern Yakut language was introduced by the Orthodox Church. The Trinity translation problem was one of the stumbling blocks. In one version of the translation, the Trinity was literally translated into Yakut language as revealed three. This is connected with the problem of the translation of the all persons of the Trinity. However, if God and Christ are more or less clear, then the Holy Spirit was a great dilemma and caused a lot of controversy in the process of translation. In translation of the Catechism into modern Yakut language in the Roman Catholic Church, the Holy Spirit is designated as Sibetetun Ayakla Nayar, meaning the holy hypostasis emanating from the God. In the Yakut language, the word spirit itself has a strong pagan connotation, associated mainly with the spirits of nature, for example, Ichi. I mentioned and describe them in the section of chapter 4. It is very important to understand that in the territory of Yakutia, the Catholic mission has been carried out for 20 years, and one of the main goals of the mission is to explain the doctrinal principles of the Catholic Church, which does not detract from the main content and the process of inculturation of Christianity. In the interview, as well as in the questionnaire that I conducted with the locals as a part of the study, the questionnaire was carried out in 2010, 2011. It was not included in the dissertation appendix. Practically each of the respondents noted that they had a clear idea of the Christian Trinity, despite the fact that this concept was hard for them to understand and accept. In interview to the question, how do you perceive the names of sacred hypostases and other names borrowed from traditional culture and used in translation? Do you understand the language of presentation and the meaning of the text, for example, gods or Jung Toyon? Respondents noted that it is much easier for them to perceive texts and concepts in Russian. This is partly due to the influence of the previous Christianization of the Republic by Orthodox missions. For Catholic missionaries, this is a kind of positive aspect, because through the Russian language, it is much easier to preach without losing the main meaning. However, it is worth saying that in remote villages, indigenous peoples do not always speak Russian. The theme of internal acceptance by local peoples of the basic doctrinal ideas of Christianity through adaptation and explanation through some elements of traditional culture seems relevant and is one of the positive ways of developing this problem in the scientific field. Of particular interest in the study regarding the last remark on the question of forms of interreligious intercultural dialogue in Yakutia, I can say that Catholic missionaries use the form of life dialogue, which includes catechesis, youth meetings, joint work informal meetings, children's playgrounds, kayaking, joint celebration of Catholic holidays, etc., where there is a direct contact with people. This form was also characterized by the respondents who were interviewed. Another important part of this form is just the organization of material humanitarian assistance to the poor among the indigenous people of the Republic. This is one of the forms that has found strong responsiveness and approval from local people. And the answer to the last question about the number of Yakuts attracted to Christianity. According to the Catholic Church in Yakutia, metric data as well as information from the abbot, about 300 people received baptism in the Catholic Church. Catholic faith was adopted by more than 80 Yakuts and Evenks. More than 40 indigenous peoples of Yakutia accepted the sacrament of anointing. 5 couples accepted the sacrament of wedding, according to the data as of 2018. Dear Piotr Konstantinovich, thank you very much for your remarks. All of them are significant. Your comments helped me to look at my work from a different perspective, from different angle. And I will certainly take into account all the comments in my further scientific work. Thank you very much. All in all, the review is positive. Dear colleagues, now we have to make a technical break. No, we are not going to have a technical break. Very nice. We have got all the members of dissertational board in the remote interactive mode. And now I would like to give the floor to the board members. Let's use alphabetical order, and my review will be after. I would like to give the floor to Doctor of Philosophy, to Professor Theresa Abalevich from Pontifical University of John Paul II, the city of Krakow. Thank you very much for your invitation. Can you hear me? Yes, we can hear you. I like this dissertation very much. I like the answers to the questions by candidates. Let me read out my review, the fragments from this review. The topic is very interesting. This topic is close to me, and thank you very much for your study. The thesis was submitted for the specialty philosophy of religion and religious studies. The topic corresponds with the specialty of religious studies, but not philosophy of religions. And the topic of inculturation of Christianity was very well studied, but in Russian science, this topic in this context is poorly studied. For this reason, we should appreciate this thesis. There was a successful attempt to analyze the inculturation of Christianity into Russian peoples. The thesis is very diverse. In the introduction, the topic and the line of research were clearly formulated. In the first chapter, the problem of culturation of Christianity in several perspectives was studied. First of all, the history of this question was studied in the documents of Roman Catholic Church. The second church develops the topic and focuses on the inculturation conducted by Catholic Church in different countries such as China and India. In the second chapter, the candidate studies the models of inculturation, and candidate focuses on visual aspects connected with the interior of the temple and so on. And also the actional aspect, chapter 4 represents the study of the specific example of inculturation and the culture of Yakuti people. The author shows how they are realized in the Yakuti ethnic-cultural environment, and the results of this study are represented in the conclusion of the thesis. The second chapter is of high interest. Field studies by the author, the stenogram of the interview with Nicholas the Mira, Father Joseph, and the interview with three press. Also photos, which explains visual and actional aspects of inculturation of Christianity in Yakutia. As a result, the study is of high, of distinct religious study character. The author refers to the sources in several languages. Our candidate has published 9 articles in the journal Religious Studies. The language of the thesis is very clear. The candidate demonstrates his independent position. The importance and originality of the topic is explained. Thus, the study is of not only local value, but also it is interested abroad. The thesis of our candidate on the topic, the acculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations and the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church, conforms with the requirements of the order from the 1st of September 2016, number 6821/1, on procedure of awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University. And the candidate, Chirkov Nikolai Viktorovich, deserve the scientific degree of the candidate of philosophy on speciality 09-0014, philosophy of religion and religious studies. Point 11 was not violated by the candidate. Thank you very much. Teresa, thank you very much. Now, let us give the floor to our candidate. Dear Teresa Semyonovna, thank you for your interest, a thorough reading and in-depth analysis of the text, as well as for the positive feedback provided for my work. There is no voice in the microphone. No, I agree with you that there is no in-depth philosophical analysis in my work, but this due to the objectives and methodology of the study. In my work, I try to be guided by the methodology of comparative religion, the principle of cultural relativism, the principle of phenomenology, the principle of comparative linguistics and hermeneutics. A philosophical analysis of the phenomenon of the inculturation of Christianity is undoubtedly of interest in the field of scientific philosophical knowledge. And perhaps in the further development of this topic, I can deepen knowledge by exploring it from the perspective of philosophical disciplines. Thank you again for appreciation of my research work. Now the floor is given to Tatiana Palamarchuk, St. Petersburg State University. I will try to read out my review. I will be as brief as possible. The thesis addresses poorly studied subject, theoretical and practical aspects of inculturation of Christianity in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. The use of term poorly studied is not formally. According to specific reasons, there are a few scientific works dedicated to the activity, to the mission of the Roman Catholic Church, especially on the territory of Russia in the, at the end of the 19th and beginning of the 20th century. And if the author would limit himself by theoretical aspects of forming the concepts of this mission, his work could be called as novel one. And the thesis is of practical value. The author considers a specific experience and acculturation of Christianity on the example of specific parishes in Yakutia. In 2014, they celebrated 25th anniversary of the restoration of the structures. Over this time, in the life of Russian Catholic community, there were a lot of events and changes. The Church acquired rich experience, including missionary one, in the broader sense of this word. Besides, it is the experience of inclusion into life of various ethnic groups and cultural traditions. Despite this fact, up to now, this experience has not become the object of logical scientific reflections, neither from academic society and or representatives of religious community. Only three theses were devoted to these problematics, but they focused either on the historical aspects of the activity of Catholic Church in the Russian Empire or on the history of idea, communism, social doctrine, modernism, and so on. And some results in pastor messages of bishops and documents of Catholic Church, but they are aimed at the solution of specific pastor problems. Any scientific research conducted in Russia and which is devoted to social and cultural aspects of Catholic Church are of high interest. The actuality is of the thesis is without doubt. And the practical significance of the work is without a doubt. The results can be used in the preparation of religious specialists, in the the thesis of our candidate consists of introduction, four chapters, and conclusions. The first chapter is of theoretical character. Special definitions are explained. It should be noted that our author is very adequate in terms of terminology and the apparatus of the definitions elaborated by the Catholic Church for the analysis of their own missionary practices. In the second chapter, our candidate reconstructs the vision of inculturation in the key documents of the Second Vatican Council and Pontifex messages. At the same time, the author does not limit himself to the restoration of the opinion of Pontifex, and he shows them in dynamic context of missionary activity in the changing world. And we understand that inculturation should be perceived not as a statical concept, but as a practice, flexible mechanism of adaptation, which is necessary in the dialogue with various ethnocultural groups. In the second chapter, inculturation is specified to historical sketches, prove it devoted to missions in India and China. Famous facts and events are described, and they allow our candidate to pay attention to an important problem. What are the limits of inculturation process? What is the border between inculturation and religious syncretism? And to what extent the penetration of ethnocultural borders changed? In chapter 3, the candidate offers analytical structure for the consideration of inculturation. The most vulnerable, in my opinion, is section 3.1, which should be more specific at the count of attraction modern literary sources. How are the models of inculturation visual, linguistic, and actional aspects? The explanation of these aspects and regional illustrative material proves the recent character of analytical scheme of our candidate. The next chapter is the original part of the thesis. Here we are talking about the inculturation into ethnical traditions of the Yakuts. The author is based on his own expedition experience and analyzes the current state and the results of the mission. Of high interest are appendixes, interviews, materials from the museums, which helps place the material into a wider context. Italy and Brazil here are necessary and positive context. Of high interest, the situation of bilingualism in Yakutia, the use of Russian and Saha, the influence on the extent of effectiveness, and the difference between literary and colloquial Saha. Also, ethnical diversity among missionaries and catechizators, local Catholics with Ukrainian and Polish origins. In this respect, the provisions of our candidate are of discursive character. The search for adequate language of self-manifestation. Over the last 35 years, this phenomenon deserves specific study. Polonisms, Latinisms, and the search for Russian analogues with strong Orthodox connotations, their acceptance or refusal, spontaneous local traditions, the attempts of regulating and unification of prayers of the church services from above are very important. Our candidate follows optimal balance between the theoretical and practical part of the research. As for the remarks, reconstructing the evolution of the phenomenon of enculturation, which existed throughout the whole history, the author addresses, considers on the text of New Testament and the Second Vatican Council. It is clear because it demonstrates the clear decisions of the Council, but the idea of the candidate about the hereditary character of the mission seventh canon of the session of the Trident Council and mission of material rich and other Jesuits is developed. You should have mentioned about Middle Ages, the understanding of the diversity of pagan peoples, among which there were potential Christians, bearers of good spirits, and non-religious people. The second moment is more considerable. Here we are talking about the specificity of order missions. These specifics of inculturation scenarios, which were defined by the order chrism, existed in Asia. Dominicans were based on autonomous discourse in California, Jesuits mission, and so on. Finally, it would be useful to include in the text of the thesis short insight into Salesian approach to the mission in the context of various ethnic groups and the existence of missionary museum has to rationalize the specific order experience. A wide range of references to the articles from reference books are doubtful. All my remarks of a private character, they don't spoil the overall positive impression from the work. It is the thesis is independent completed research. It makes an original contribution into the development of modern religious studies. As for the moral form, the thesis of Chirkov, Nikolai Viktorovich, on the topic, the inculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church conforms with the main requirements stated by the order number 6821/1 on procedure for awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate deserves the degree of on speciality of philosophy of religion and religious studies. Point 11 was not violated by our candidate. Thank you very much, distinguished Anastasia Andreevna. Nikolai Viktorovich, the floor is yours. Dear Anastasia Andreevna, first of all, I want to thank you for your interest in my dissertation research. Thank you for the detailed recommendations and comments, as well as for the high appreciation and positive feedback for the dissertation. I completely agree with all the points you indicated in the response to my work. In response to some comments, I would like to give more detailed explanation. As for remark one, I'm very grateful to you for the no voice in the microphone. Regarding this aspect in my work, I really turn only to the text of the New Testament and documents of the era of the Second Vatican Council, as well to the post-conciliar period in the Roman Catholic Church with the aim of demonstrating the formation of the official documented view of the Catholic Church on this issue. Your recommendation in particular, an appeal to the historical milestones of the Council to Trident, the seventh canon of the 24th session, as well as to the text History Against the Gentiles by Pavel Orosius, which can rightfully be called one of the key works of the early Christian and medieval European historiography. Of course, this topic deserves not only religious studies, but also a direct appeal to historical texts and records, which in one way or another reflected the moments of formation of views on this issue. Your recommendation interested me, and in the further development of the topic of my dissertation research, I will definitely take it into account in order to provide a deeper analysis of this issue as part of a separate chapter in the planned monograph. As for remark two, this remark is absolutely true. Indeed, the specificity of the method of inculturation of Christianity depends on the specifics of the monastic congregation carrying out missionary activity in a particular region or country. The specifics of the order are always determined by the charisma of the order, its founder. In my research, I did not focus on this point because I tried to illustrate the phenomenon of the inculturation of Christianity itself. However, in my dissertation, based on the ethnocultural locations of field studies, I turned most of all to historical examples of the activities of the Jesuit order in India and China. Because in my opinion, there are some of the illustrative examples of the specificity of the inculturation of Christianity in Asia. I want to point out that the Roman Catholic Church monastic orders are divided into contemplative and missionary. Each missionary congregation carries out missionary activity in a specific region, the specifics of which are also determined by the local components and challenges of the congregation. The Jesuit order, known in the Roman Catholic Church and in the world for the fact that the Jesuits were one of the first to search for ways and methods of inculturating Christianity in India, China, and Japan, thereby became famous as pioneers, evangelizers, embarking on an innovative approach to missionary activity in these countries. It seems very interesting that useful to look at the issue of approaches to the inculturation of Christianity in individual missionary congregations. As for the Order of Salesians, which was founded by John Bosco in Turin in 1859, it should be noted that the founder himself wanted the evangelization of youth in the spirit of Salesian charisma to spread outside Italy. His dream was to establish a Salesian mission in China. However, historically, the first Salesian mission was founded in Patagonia. On the 11th of November, 1875, a group of first missionaries traveled to Argentina, where at first the Salesians evangelized children and youth from Italy who came to work, and 4 years later, in 1879, Salesians first made contact with the Indian tribes of Patagonia and opened the first missionary houses. Direct work with poor children and youth. Once again, I thank you for the good recommendation, which opens up a new opportunity for me to consider, identify, conduct a comparative analysis of the specifics of war missions in the process of inculturating Christianity in the Russian Roman Catholic Church. Dear Anastasia Andreevna, I thank you once again for the positive feedback on the dissertation, the comments and recommendations that have already helped me to look at certain aspects of the research from a different research angle. I will certainly take into account every moment in further research work. Dear colleagues, I would like to give the floor to Doctor of Philosophy, to Tatiana Chumakova. Dear colleagues, I will shorten my review because it is placed on the website of St. Petersburg State University. The thesis on the topic, the inculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church, is on the actual topic connected with the adaptation of church studies, religious and cultural traditions among different ethnical groups. The theoretical significance is that for the third time in the Russian regional studies, the history of the question of acculturation of Christianity is accentuated. The author defined the models and aspect of inculturation. A very important thing is that our candidate did not limit himself by the theory of this phenomena. He also conducted field research in Yakutia and abroad. The thesis of our candidate can be characterized as fundamental, which is proved by the plan of the thesis, which consists of introduction and 4 chapters. I'll skip this. I would like to emphasize that the literary list is very diverse, both in Russian and in English. The thesis is very scrupulous and qualitative and very clear. The provisions for the defense are logical and explained in the thesis. Among the provisions, I would like to highlight the provision connected with the 3 aspects. A visual aspect of inculturation of Christianity. Christianity involves the notions of exterior and exterior of Catholic temples is one of the most significant methods of preaching of Christian religious study. Linguistic aspects manifests itself in translations and Holy Spirit, translation of Holy Spirit into local languages. Actional aspects is explained by the search of new forms of cultural practice of and prayers of Roman Catholic Church. As I may see, the thesis of Chirkov, Nikolai Viktorovich, the inculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of the nations in the missionary activity of Roman Catholic Church is of practical significance both for pedagogical activity and for further research work in this sphere of religious studies. Nevertheless, such qualitative thesis and the thesis of Chirkov, Nikolai Viktorovich is not deprived by some drawbacks. He writes, among Russian publications, we don't see the works devoted to the description of the methods of inculturation of Christianity into the peoples of Republic of Sakha. This problematics was described in the scientific article, the contribution of Vinyamidov into the peoples of Northeast Asia was written. I would like to advise you to study the with the work of Dmitry Vladimirovich Azutov, who in 2007 defended his candidate thesis, Shores and Northern Altai People, at the beginning of the 19th and 20th century. The materials of the thesis were partly published in the articles by Arzutov. It is a small remark that does not influence on the influence the positive impression from the thesis. The thesis of Chirkov Nikolai Viktorovich on the topic, the inculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations, conforms with the main requirements stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016 on the procedure for awarding degrees at St. Petersburg State University. And our candidate Nikolai Viktorovich deserves the degree of the candidate of philosophical sciences on speciality 09-00-14, philosophy of religion and religion studies. Point 11 of this order was not violated by the candidate. Nikolai Viktorovich, please be so kind to distinguished Tatiana Vitautasovna, first of all, I thank you for your remark and recommendation for the further research path. I am glad that my work made a positive impression on you. In my dissertation, voicing the idea that among domestic publications we did not meet the works devoted to the description of the aspects and methods of enculturation of the ethic tradition of the peoples of the Republic of Sakha Yakutia in the missionary work of the Roman Catholic Church, on the basis of which this process and its components are described in the work. In the framework of our country, I wanted to emphasize the methods and aspects implemented in the framework of inculturation of Christianity in Yakutia and in the missionary activities of the Roman Catholic Church. However, it should be recognized that this formulation may not be entirely successful. I admit that I am not familiar with the works of Dmitry Vladimirovich Artus. However, thank you for this comment, which may really help me expand my view on the problem of interaction of traditional beliefs and Christianity in further scientific research. Dear Tatiana Vitoasovna, once again, thank you for the appreciation of the dissertation and the positive feedback provided. Thank you very much, Nikolai Viktorovich. I hope Tatiana Vitoasovna is satisfied with your answer. Please, I would like to give the floor to an expert Екатерина Сергеевна Элбекян, Doctor of Philosophy, Professor, famous, our expert in the sphere of Western Christianity of the Russian Presidential Academy of National Economy and Public Administration. Екатерина Сергеевна, the floor is yours. I would like to be as brief as possible. The topicality and relevance of the is without doubt. It is stipulated by the problem of the adaptation of Christianity, Catholicism into ethnocultural environment. As you may know, the Second Vatican Council was very important in the history. And the thesis is reasoned, and it used the methods adequate to the tasks and goals of the research, in particular historical reconstruction methods of comparative analysis, interview, and included supervision, which allowed to conduct such diverse study connected with inculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations and the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. The main dignity of the word is a wide range of literary resources and wide in-depth analysis. The scientific novelty of the thesis is in the fact that the author made an attempt, there is no voice in attempt to conduct complex analysis of the inculturation of Christianity. Can you hear me? Yes, we can. The important moment concerning the novelty is that the author gives his own definition of inculturation, and he explains it and defines various models of inculturation of Christianity by Roman Catholic Church. Scientific and practical value was mentioned. It is a completed scientific research. And it is very considerable research. It is of practical and theoretical character. The results of the research were published in 12 articles, and their content conforms with the requirements of the thesis. And also the results were discussed in 12 reports and as in any successful work, any successful work can't be deprived of drawbacks. On the whole, I highly appreciate the quality of the research which was conducted. I would like to read out my remarks and recommendations according to the text of the thesis, but pay attention, these remarks don't spoil the overall positive impression from the thesis. In the first chapter, the author studies the problem of the study, but the methodology of the study is questionable. Excessive descriptivism led to the lack of concepts. The second remark. In first and second chapters of the thesis, the author concludes that in the process of inculturation of Christianity, there is the transformation of traditional religions, beliefs of indigenous peoples under the influence of inculturation religious study. But on the other hand, this religious study acquires new forms and elements and acquires hostile components. for example, specific transformation in ecclesiology of the Roman Catholic Church, then the candidate analyzes this phenomenon and uses the examples. But it's not obvious that in religious studies of Roman Catholic Church there are transformations, because we know that under religious study we understand some contents and constant formulations. The author does not point out other areas. In the text, we see new forms of church services among non-Christian people, but this provision is not very well explained. In the third paragraph of the third chapter, the author highlights the accent of inculturation. The thesis poses generalized historical examples. Such examples are not enough, and they don't correlate with other paragraphs where visual and actual aspects of Christianity are described. As the author concludes, the linguistic aspect of inculturation is a separate topic which requires not only substantial analysis from the position of linguistic and religious studies comparativistics. And finally, remark 4 in chapter 4, on the basis of the collected material from scientific expeditions, it would be interesting to consider the phenomenon of enculturation of Christianity from the position of the psychology of religion. Nevertheless, these remarks don't influence the study, and they are my advice to the author. On the whole, the thesis of Chirkov Nikolai Viktorovich on the topic, the enculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of nations in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church, conforms with the main requirements of the order number 6821/1 on procedure of awarding of academic degrees in St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate deserves the degree of the candidate of philosophy on specialty 090014, philosophy of religion and religious studies. Point 11 of this order was not violated by our candidate. Thank you for your attention. Nikolai Viktorovich, the floor is yours. Екатерина Сергеевна, thank you very much for your review. I would like to give some explanation. Remark 1. I agree with your remark. The bias towards the narrative historical interpretation is partly justified by the objectives of the study. One of the important tasks of this dissertation research was to demonstrate the phenomenon of the inculturation of Christianity in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church and to present a holistic characterization of this process. Therefore, an attempt was made to systematize and analyze the existing approaches to determining the inculturation of Christianity in foreign and domestic studies, as well as the interpretation of this concept in the Catholic Church creed, official documents and writings of the pontiffs of the Roman Catholic Church. I tried to avoid subjective and ideological market judgments. Perhaps all this together could contribute to the fact that in some places in the first chapter of the paper there are repetitions as well as the lack of conceptual conclusions. I completely agree with the remark made, and I will certainly take it into account in my future scientific work. Remark two, the objectives of my dissertation research including examining the existing models of the inculturation of Christianity in the missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church, identifying aspects of inculturation of Christianity in the missionary activities of the Roman Catholic Church, and accordingly the description based on the historical modern examples of the inculturation of Christianity in the cultures of my research regions. It should be noted that the topic of the study of transformations that arise in the process of inculturation of Christianity requires further study, suggesting, first of all, a more in-depth study of the other aspects of theology of the Roman Catholic Church. Undoubtedly, these problems require competence in the field of a number of theological disciplines. In these dissertations, I try to adhere to the position of academic religious studies, in particular, the methodology of comparative religion, the principle of cultural relativism, the principle of phenomenology, the principles of comparative linguistics and hermeneutics. Despite this, I am grateful for the remark made because it helped me to look at one of the further possibilities for developing the research topic, to identify transformations from the position of some theological disciplines of the Roman Catholic Church. As for remark three, and the objectives of the study were to identify the aspects of the enculturation of Christianity in the missionary activities of the Roman Catholic Church, as well as the description based on historical and modern examples of the enculturation of Christianity in the cultures of the regions of our research. It was not possible to cover the ethno-religious components of all regions in this dissertation. Therefore, several of the most accessible regions were identified for objective and subjective reasons. My goal was to illustrate the linguistic aspect, its presence in the strategy of inculturation of Christianity in the missionary work of the Roman Catholic Church in non-Christian cultures. In my work, the most striking examples of this problem were used, in my opinion. Of course, this topic requires the possession of the necessary competences in the language sphere. As for remark four, the aspect of transformation, thank you for the recommendation. This aspect was not included in the objectives of this dissertation research. The dissertation only indicates the problem of possible transformations that arise among the indigenous peoples of Yakutia in the process of inculturation of Christianity and its possible study. Undoubtedly, this question seems to be interesting for study from the perspective of the psychology of religion. I continue to develop this area of research, analyze the material collected in ethno-religious studies expedition in Yakutia. The results of this study will be presented in the form of scientific articles in one of peer-reviewed journals recommended by the High Attestation Commission. Thank you very much. I hope Ekaterina Sergeyevna is satisfied with the answer of our candidate. Nikolai Viktorovich, please take this seat. Please allow me to read out my review. I will try to be as brief as possible. The actuality of the topic is stipulated by considerable scientific and public interest towards the problems of inculturation, the study of the interaction of culture in the modern globalizing world, the discussions about cultural appropriation in the frames of cultural critics or in the discussions of traditional values in the frames of conservative discourse leads to the necessity to and role of those social and cultural phenomena which is traditionally named as a missionary activity, and its task is the inculturation of Christianity. Of high interest is the fact that in the process of enculturation, there is not only the transformation of local culture, but also Christian religious studies acquires new forms and elements. The reasonable character of the conclusions and findings in the thesis is without doubt. He was based on solid theoretical and methodological basis and his own empirical studies Our candidate was based on theoretical principles and provisions of anthropology and theory of culture, which uncover the essence of the enculturation phenomenon. He was based on the principle of cultural relativism, used the method of phenomenon description, and used the method of comparative analysis from the point of view of the process of acculturation and interreligious interaction, and the application of this methodology corresponds with the aims and goals of the study. The scientific novelty of the thesis is that here for the first time the history of enculturation of Christianity into the ethnic traditions of Yakuts were reconstructed. The fact that our candidates systematized the approaches to the defining of enculturations and analyzed various aspects of the explanation of this phenomenon in the Catholic religious studies, in official documents of the Roman Catholic Church, within the period of 1985 to 2013, new field materials were collected by our candidate, and they were represented in six appendixes to the thesis. The main scientific findings within the frames of this study are the following. I will read out main theses. The essence of his scientific results. The first one, enculturation of Christianity is the strategy of its dissemination in the basis of which there is the study of the culture of Christianized peoples, the adaptation of this culture to the Christian norms and the inclusion into the process of evangelization of the components of worldview and culture of the language of Christianized people. Enculturation of Christianization is a social-cultural process, the results of which can be met in different countries where Catholic missionaries conduct their missionary activity in terms of dissemination and adaptation of Christianity among local peoples and cultures. Currently, the enculturation of Christianity is one of the leading principles of missionary activity of the Roman Catholic Church. The development of aspects, methods, and forms of the enculturation of Christianity received theological explanation in the decrees of the Second Vatican Council and in the Pope messages. The enculturation of Christianity plays an important role in the development of interreligious and intercultural dialogues in the Roman Catholic Church. Then, a very important remark, the process of enculturation of Christianity is mutual. On the one hand, there is a transformation of traditional religious beliefs of the indigenous peoples under the influence of Catholic belief, and on the other hand, Catholic religious study receives new forms, acquires hostile components. The strategy of enculturation of Christianity is realized by Catholic missionaries in Yakutia. It is described in detail in chapter 4. And they used by missionaries in acculturation of Christianity. And from my point of view, it seems to me that it is the most interesting point. There is mutual transformation of two collided structure, local Yakuti culture, and the appearance of religious syncretism is negative from the point of view of the Roman Catholic Church, but the thesis the theoretical and practical significance of this study, expands scientific imagination in the process of Christian inculturation. The results social and cultural anthropology, and also the thesis was probed at conferences, and the main findings were published in scientific articles. And informants and the data, it is a very important source. They agreed to point out, to publish their names. Without doubt, it is a very positive step. Either respondents should be hidden behind their names. And only the name of the priest, which is official figure, should be left. In conclusion, in my opinion, the dissertation Inculturation of Christianity of the Roman Catholic conforms with the requirements from the 1st of September 20, and our candidate Nikolai Viktorovich Chirkov deserves the degree of the candidate of philosophical sciences on speciality 09-0014, philosophy of religion and religious studies. Point 11 was not violated by our candidate, Nikolai Viktorovich. The floor is yours, distinguished Mariana Mikhailovna. I would like to express my gratitude for your interest for my dissertation research, and I'm very grateful to you for the problems of reconstruction and evolution of the phenomenon of inculturation of Christianity, primarily as a historian and the respondents were agreed in the written form. And I agree with your opinion. In order to preserve private information, thank you very much for your remark. Distinguished Nikolai Viktorovich, I am satisfied with your answer. Well, everyone had the floor. Dear colleagues, non-board members, would you like to have the floor? There is no voice in the microphone. The review of Andrei Pavlovich Zabiyaka, the scientific supervisor, he says about topicality and practical value of the thesis. Uh, Chirkov Nikolai Viktorovich, since 2012, was a postgraduate student at the University of Amur. He was very responsible and hardworking researcher then. The scientific supervisor says about the topicality and novelty, practical value. And this thesis has a high scientific level. And the provisions for the defense are clearly formulated and explain the topic of the work was clearly explained. The publication of the author reflects the main content of the thesis. Thus, it is a completed scientific research which conforms with the requirements for the thesis, and our candidate deserves the candidate degree of philosophy on speciality 09 or 014, philosophy of religion and religious studies. Doctor of Philosophy. Well, would you like to have the floor to say something? Dear colleagues, we have to discuss the question of awarding or not awarding the degree. Please switch off the broadcast of the meeting, and colleagues who are not members of the dissertation council, I ask you to leave the hall. I will invite you when our consultation meeting is over. Distinguished candidate, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please switch on the live broadcast of the meeting. We are going to have an open roll vote. It is a peculiarity of the defendants of the thesis at St. Petersburg State University. I raise the question of awarding an academic degree to an open roll call. Distinguished Professor Balevich, your opinion, please. Professor Balevich, are you in favor of awarding the academic degree to our candidate? Yes, I agree. Anastasia Andreevna, and you, are you for or against? I am for and support our candidate. Tatiana Vituasovna, I am for. Екатерина Сергеевна, what about you? I am for. It is brilliant work and brilliant defense. Екатерина Сергеевна, thank you very much. My opinion is for and support my colleagues. The defense was brilliant. Distinguished colleagues, out of five participants, five members voted for. There are no those who abstained from vote, and the decision on awarding the academic degree of the candidate of philosophy on speciality 090014, philosophy of religion and religious studies, was accepted. Thank you very much. I would like to say that a few words, distinguished board members, colleagues and guests, I would like to express my gratitude. Confucius said, find the work which you will fall in love into, and you won't be hardworking for the rest of your life. And my thesis proves it, his words. I would like to express my gratitude for field researchers in different countries and different cultures where I met a lot of wonderful people, got acquainted with many scholars who helped me to broaden my horizons. I would like to express my gratitude to Mr. Zabiyaka, Doctor of Philosophy, who supported me. I would like to express my gratitude to my parents, you board members, for your interest towards my work and for this meeting of this dissertation council. Mariana Mikhailovna, I am grateful to you. Also, I would like to express my gratitude to the workers of St. Petersburg State University and St. Petersburg State University, where I was honored to defend my thesis. Also, I would like to thank all the guests. Thank you very much. Nikolai Viktorovich, thank you very much. Dear colleagues, I would like to thank the Secretary Office of the Scientific Secretary of St. Petersburg State University for Mrs. Khrushcheva and technical services who did their best to make this meeting of the Dissertational Council possible. And I would like to express my gratitude to everyone who presented today. The meeting is declared closed. Thank you for your participation.